You already started it? Go ahead with that scripture you were talking about. First one, give all praises to
Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai. Double honors to the apostles, the GMS. We finna get it in.
Wisdom of Solomon 17:1. For great are thy judgments and cannot be expressed. Therefore unnutrient souls have erred. For when unrighteous men thought up oppressed the holy nation, they being shut up in their houses, the prisoners of darkness, and feathered with the bonds of long night, laid their exile from the eternal providence. For while they supposed to lie hid in their secret sins, they were scattered under a dark veil of forgetfulness. Being horribly astonished and terrible with strange apparitions.
And where I was going. That's what I was thinking about all day. But the spirits can be let loose and shit. And I was thinking about the 9/11, how,
demons and the smoke and fire and all that.
They went crazy, so they like jumped out the building and shit. So I was like thinking, like,
you ever seen the videos when they break? You can see demons in the smoke.
That's real too.
Yeah, that's real. Cause that whole thing was a satanic offering to the devil. With all them lives, all them souls, that was the, like, it's just a big offering.
Sacrifice.
Yeah, sacrifice. That's why you think they used to put them babies in the fire. They'd actually have to see demons and shit come out the fire. That's why they kept doing it.
You got them watching the movie. What's that movie called? The Cabin? Cabin of the Woods. You ever seen that? Sacrifice motherfucking shit. For neither might the corner that hid them kept them from fear, but noises as of waters falling down sounded about them. Instead, the sad visions appeared unto them with heavy countenance. No power of the fire might give them light, neither could the bright flames of the stars endure to lighten the whole night. Only there appeared unto them a fire kindled of itself, very dreadful, for being much terrified, they thought the things which they saw to be worse than the thought they saw not. As for the illusions of art magic, they were put down in their vaulting, and wisdom was reproved with disgrace. For they that promised to drive away terrors and troubles from a sick soul were sick themselves of fear, worthy to be laughed at. For though no terrible thing did fear them, yet being scared with wild beasts passed by and hissing of serpents, they died for fear, denying that they saw the error which could of no side be avoided.
Here we go. That's it, right?
Where's you at?
So, 17, it's okay. 17. But,
Yeah, because these people out here, they really into some witchcraft and shit, man.
Yeah, I'm fucking with them familiar spirits and shit. You know? Now, eventually, them fucking spirits gonna turn against these motherfuckers.
That's like, because they even tell you, like, Beyonce, she told you that she was possessed by the demon of, Sasha Fierce.
You can see them at one concert. They got all kind of photos on the internet at that same concert, man. It didn't even look like her anymore, man. She was hideous as fuck, man. Like the video Kanye West got when the demon came up out of his ass.
Oh, yeah, he puked up the demon or something.
Mm-hmm.
That's some crazy shit.
She had like a, I think it was a knife or something in her neck. Beyonce?
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah, but all these rappers, musicians, they're all devil worshipers. That's why you ever hear that Eminem song? You want to hear the most evil song ever made? You think it'd be made by like Slayer or something, right? No, it was made by Biggie Smalls and Eminem. I was listening to that song Dead Wrong. You ever listen to that shit? When Eminem came in and said there's several different levels of devil worshiping, human sacrifice and cannibalism, having sex with horses and rabbits and
That's the time we in now. That's why they raising them temples and bow everywhere now.
Have you noticed that's why they ain't killed your boy Eminem? Anybody else, they would have killed by that age already.
That's crazy.
Sexual fantasies. Sexual abilities and shit. Yeah, that's just why how when Barack Obama got elected, that was it the night he got elected, his grandma died, didn't she? What is his mom or grandma? Oh, he sacrificed that hoe.
I can't remember.
No, it wasn't his mom, it was his grandma. His mom was a white woman. Yes. So he made his little offering right there as soon as he got his deal in. As soon as he got elected, he threw up his little demonic offering. And these people, they'll sacrifice their own family members. They don't care.
It's for a chase of a dog, man. It's for a chase of rolling up and down these streets in some so-called fly-ass car and shit.
Who's that American Idol bitch that sacrificed all of her children?
That's all
family?
I'm thinking about. The one, Jennifer.
Jennifer Hudson?
Yeah. She killed her whole goddamn family.
Her whole fucking family.
And you know what? Check it out. When that bitch be in the movies and shit, why you think she can act so good? Because she goes back to that memory. She summons that shit of her family, loss of her family, and she, you know? And them tears go flowing. That's a technique when it comes to acting and shit, man. That's why some of these actors can just get into their role and they be sincerely crying and shit. Because they thinking about all them assassinations they participated in.
Yeah, when you read the Bible, you go through the Book of Kings and all that. It always talks about how the different kings sent their child through the fire to Molech or to Baal.
Is it okay? They don't give a damn.
Now, oh, you know what? Even, you know, abortions is the actual satanic sacrifice. I've heard doctors come out and they admitted that they was in the Church of Satan. They're a high priest of Satan, and they performed abortions. And while they did the abortion, they had a ceremony, a ritual while they did it. Yeah, I heard that on Jeff Rentz. You can probably go back in the archives and find an interview. I forget his name.
That would be out your mind, you trusting doctors. A new video just went up. This black bitch down in the hospital with the doctor who was performing the surgery on her before the surgery, like a dumbass. Well, anyway, she had a weed and she hid a recording device in her weed. And during the motherfucking surgery, the doctors, the nurses, the anesthesiologists, everybody is talking shit about this black bitch, man. They clowning on her, man. They was clowning on the bitch. Found on her body, where she looked, saying how stupid her family was, how dumb her husband was to be with her. And she wasn't even bad looking.
I got another point to add to that real quick.
Dumbass doctors, man.
What's that scripture you was reading? Wisdom of Solomon.
Where'd it go?
Wisdom of Solomon 17, right? Hold on a second. I'm going to read that again. I'm going to break something down real quick.
Are we trying to put the emphasis on Israel, though? Instead of just faggot ass Esau?
Esau's a bitch. Look, Wisdom of Solomon 17:7. As for the illusions of art magic, they were put down and their vaunting of wisdom was reproved with disgrace. But what's that, the illusions they got Esau uses on our people today? It's the illusions that are art and magic. And the art, like the artists, you know, the musicians, the actors, they cast spells on your ass. And like a spell. To cast a spell means you spelling out words and you using words. That's what it means to cast out a spell. It means you spell words. And they use those words in the music and the movies to brainwash your dumbass. They put cast a spell on you with all this wicked music and all these evil movies they make you watch. Y'all sitting at home chilling watching Netflix. All these TV shows was all about adultery, all about blasphemy, all about murder. And that's what people love. What was you saying? I just want to throw that in there because that goes in part of they satanic bullshit that they be practicing.
Hold on, I got a scripture.
What's that?
This is Jeremiah 5 and I'm going to start at 26. For among my people are found wicked men. They lay wait as he that set of snares that set a trap. They catch men. Choose their own delusions. Is that you talking about Ecclesiastes 39?
As Isaiah 66. 4.
Okay, you're thinking of another one. There's another one.
Oh, look, you said I'm in there now. You said I stepped my... Come on, yeah.
Was that a Samsung?
Yeah, Derek hooked me up. He just gave it to me.
I've been using that old bullet. I had the same cell phone since 2010.
It's 2006.
I finally got some shit that actually works. Samsung.
Dude, got some memory in it?
16 gigabytes. And it's better than what I had. That's why I just got them scriptures quick now, boy.
Let me start at 27. As a cage is full of birds, so are their houses full of deceit. Therefore, they are become great and waxing rich. They are waxing fat. They shine, yea. They overpass the deeds of the wicked.
Oh, that's Israel. Israel overpassed the weeds of the dick, the deeds of the wicked. You know what I'm saying? Look at our people. Our people are wicked as hell, man. Well, all of our women are whores. They walk around pussy showing, titties showing. The men are a bunch of faggots, adulterers. You know what I'm saying? Just pieces, just worthless piles of shit, man. That's our people. Just fucking worthless.
You see that dude in Texas got arrested for looking at that bitch's pussy?
Oh, yeah?
Hey, man, he's playing, man. This devil about to come down.
Oh, speaking of that, this is off topic, but you see your boy Will Smith died from Ohio State. He got shot.
I didn't know he played for Ohio State.
Oh, no, not the actor.
I didn't know he played for Ohio State.
Yeah, he was on that national. Wasn't he on the national? Yeah,
class of 2002.
Yeah, he's on the national championship team. I have no idea. And then he won a Super Bowl with the Saints.
I was reading about it, and it's all kind of shit. They, you know, it was on the comic board saying it was another player that did it that he had beef with.
But that's good he got shot, though.
Yeah, right.
You know, he was wicked as hell. Doing all kind of foul shit. It's gonna be more, man. More and more death that's coming, man. That's what's coming. A lot more.
It's gonna multiply like a motherfucker. They judge not the cause of the fatherless, yet they prosper. And the right of the needy do they not judge. That motherfucker was driving a Mercedes SUV.
Man.
You know, and the dude that hit him was driving a Hummer, the H2.
Man.
You know? So it was some beef, probably some adultery shit.
Probably was.
Or something, you know? That's the only reason why a motherfucker kill somebody, man.
Yeah, you get killed for over adultery.
Yeah. Most times,
that do you like OJ. That's a punishment for adultery, though, death.
Death. That's right.
Death.
Shall I not visit for these things, said the Lord? Shall not my soul be avenged on such a nation as this? A wonderful and horrible thing is committed in the land. The prophets prophesy falsely, and the priests bear rule by their means, and by the people, and my people love to have it so, and what will ye do in the end thereof?
Our people, they love lies more than truth. You know what I'm saying? Because if you tell our people the truth, we give them the truth, tell them that they're Israelite. If we teach them about, you know, all the conspiracy theories, if we tell them the fluoride's in the water or the vaccinations hurt your children, they'll get mad at you instead of mad at the people who lied and is deceiving you.
Yeah.
They'll get mad at you for talking about it instead of getting mad at the person to put the fluoride in the water. You know what I'm saying? If you tell them that celebrating Easter is not in the Bible and that celebrating Christmas is devil worshiping, which it is, they'll get mad at you, you know what I'm saying, for exposing the lies of their favorite pork chop eating preacher. You know what I'm saying? They'll get mad at you. Like, you was the one that did something wrong,
right?
Because you told the truth.
That was the problem. That was the problem. And the time of year we in now is spring break time. These motherfuckers traveling everywhere. And that's when wickedness is at an all-time high.
Oh, yeah, them whores go down to Mexico.
This time of year.
I've been to the Mexico spring break party back when I was young. And, man, there's so many whores down there.
You see that bitch from somewhere.
Damn, all them buses left and I could breathe now.
She went to Cancun and she dropped dead, man, somehow. Mysteriously yesterday. Fine bitch too, man. Oh, fine, you like bitch.
I couldn't breathe when all them buses were down here.
I know they spin out on them toxic fumes and shit. What's up with High Street? Was that closed? Fuck weird. Get those weirdos on camera.
I appreciate it.
That's Bansky, you know, trying to spot. What's his name? The artist.
Banksy. Banksy probably. make no bank excuses.
What are those?
What are those? Get them on camera and say, what are those?
Okay, let me read this. I'm going to start it. This is Jeremiah 47. And I'm going to start at 1. There's a lot of reading on here because it's going into a lot of these Chaldeans and their witchcraft and all that wicked shit.
Yeah, that's the originators of all the witchcraft.
The Chaldeans.
Yeah, that's the Babylonians.
Yeah. Canaanites. Come down.
You know, even I believe that the word Chaldean in Hebrew goes back to the word dealing with the stars, too, because they was all into astrology and shit.
Right.
You know, the origin of all that wicked astrology all go back to ancient Babylon. That's where the Greeks learned it from. They tell you that. The Greeks tell you that, too.
Right, right. And you notice, hell, man, it's getting crazy with it now, man. It's now on RT News. The RT News is talking about Planet Nibiru and shit.
Oh, yeah. Well, I heard Dmitry Medvedev said that there was different alien races living amongst us. So they throwing out.
Well, he's right. Different tribes.
Oh, yeah, there are different tribes.
Let's give him some credit for that.
But they started to throw out all kind of bullshit though out there, like that flat Earth shit. I didn't know that flat Earth shit was that serious. Like I seen the elders.
I didn't think it was serious.
Like, they was cursing out them dudes in GMS for teaching it. This shit is getting worse. I was actually spent my morning battling some fool over flat Earth.
Oh, I had fun.
I actually had to explain to him of how the Earth is not flat. They actually believe this shit.
It was flat. How the hell could we have mountains? Mountains are not flat.
Come on, motherfuckers, this is all some other shit, man. Hold on, let me read this real quick.
They look like they've been hiking through the Swiss Alps.
Got him.
And found a mobike to ride.
Get him. Yodelay, yee-hoo.
Damn, look how skinny jeans are, boy.
It's just so tight. His damn eyeballs are about to pop out.
That shit is. God damn.
You can hang somewhere with that shit. God damn.
He saw just a big, funny-looking faggot.
Here we
man.
Go, RT.
Then, like the scripture said, is this the man? Is this the man that made the earth tremble?
Planet X to really cause mass extinction this month. They saying this month.
They say that every month. They got a new Nibiru date.
Yeah, but I'm tripping. This is RT, though.
Yeah, but RT's Russian propaganda still.
Yeah, but they still come out with
some truth. Yeah, they do come out with some truth.
Y'all want me to read something?
Yeah, read some of that crazy shit.
This is from RT News. The elusive Planet X, or Nibiru, with its unimaginable long 27 million year. That's crazy, man. Now, how do they figure that shit? 27 million year orbit.
What happened is they got high on some ayahuasca. You know what I'm saying? Sat down with one of them Israelite scholars down in South America. They went on a spirit walk. And then they got some visions.
They was eating a mushroom.
Yeah.
Well, they was hanging with, what's the cowboy movie? The Young Boys, Young Guns.
Oh, yeah, Young Guns. I was eating that peyote.
It's still only a theory to many, but one astrophysicist believes it spells doom for Earth.
It said one astrophysicist.
It says doom for Earth, though. Don't the scripture says Earth will abide forever?
The scriptures do say the Earth will abide forever.
Nibiru's arrival this month, he says, will bring about a mass extension of untold proportions. Now, we already know we saw it's going to do some bullshit miracle shit. We already know something.
All lying with all lying wonders.
Right,
I'll get that. I'm gonna get that.
Wait, is that Matthew 24 or Luke? Come on over here. It's for y'all to hear this. It's for y'all. This is how y'all. This is your salvation right here. This is how y'all gonna make it. The celestial body theorized in many in ancient texts, most notably among the Sumerians.
Y'all, it's under perdition scripture.
It's predicted to be 10 times our size. And is currently still thousands of times further away from us than our sun. But if the latest research is correct, something is having a skewing effect on a group of objects in the Kuiper belt, just beyond Neptune, and is closing in fast.
Oh, the Kepler belt.
Thanks to scientists, we know that the larger the celestial body, the bigger its gravity, and consequently its ability to affect others, smaller bodies around it. We've known of Jupiter's crucial role in protecting us from asteroids for quite some time.
So they
now.
Say Nibiru is a planet or a sun? They saying it's a planet?
Oh, yeah, they saying it's a planet.
I heard before other people say it was a sun. They said our solar system's actually binary solar system.
Oh, my goodness.
You know,
more mischievous.
See, because people try to come on the comment boards and act like we don't know nothing about all the different theories that are out there. We know about the Anunnaki bullshit, you know, ancient aliens.
My fault. What? That shit up there just said, fun family fun, come on the AIDS walk.
Did it really? Did you get on camera?
No,
I believe it's
going to pop back up.
So family fun is going on an AIDS walk. See, that's America for you. You got to have a fun family time with AIDS. Go figure that out. Only in America. Just like Don King would say, only in America.
But the mysterious Nibiru could very well do the opposite, and some say there's good reason to believe it. According to wide speculation among the space surveying community, we were never likely to observe Nibiru closely, owing to its long orbit. However, once it makes its theoretical journey back around, it's going to bring with it more than just a pretty sight. These motherfuckers, this is Babylonian astrology, man. This is madness, this is some crazy shit.
Because when you read the ancient Babylonian Sumerian stories about Nibiru, if I'm not mistaken, Nibiru was like a goddess or something. You know what I'm saying? It was not a planet. And then they'll say Tiamat was a planet, you know, where you got the asteroid belt past Mars. They say that's the remains of an ancient planet that had collided with the Earth. Some crazy shit.
Yeah, I read that it was the Earth that collided with the Moon that caused that.
See, there you go.
It's all kind of bullshit. Oh, my goodness.
Hey, that's just some of the whacked out shit that's out there, man.
Yeah, you get a migraine sitting down with scientists talking to that food.
See, you know, but people will believe that shit, but they'll say the Bible's bullshit. But go figure.
So, they
don't make no sense.
Some say the mass extinction some 27 million years ago was caused by just that. Comets and other space debris pummeling Earth and wiping everything out. And we indeed have fossil evidence to suggest that.
Huh.
Really. With striking regularity, something wiped out almost all life once in every 27 million years. Now, where'd they get that from?
There's no way to possibly prove it.
Mm-mm. Hey, you'd be a fool to even argue with a fool that wants to argue with you about that. Dating back, well, we can argue with the scriptures. Dating back at least 250 million fucking years. I gotta get the scripture.
I got a scripture for you. Yeah, because like he said before, you know, Esau, he can make something appear in the sky that's not really there, too. You know what I mean? Everybody knows about the Project Blue Beam. You see, China just recently, again, they've been making whole cities appear in the sky. You see that?
Yeah, that shit, they picking up steam, and it's getting better and better at
technology.
Yeah, they're getting
better and better at it.
I think it's done, man. I think they're ready. I think they're ready, man.
Boy, they,
as a matter of fact, I know they are. I said my opinion. I know they're ready.
Well, you can see the way they're moving now. Yes. You see how they got the division. They got all the people divided against each other, just as they planned, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
With their politics.
And
they're
picking up steam.
Yeah, we know with Donald Trump versus the Republicans and the Democrats versus Donald Trump and the blacks versus the whites and the Mexicans.
That's what I was about to say, because you watch any movie now, especially the ones that have come out the last few years, it's always something extreme. Some white people talking about niggas, or the black people talking about white people, devil crap, you know, on and on. It's in every movie now, man.
And these people, they do as exactly as they're programmed to do.
Exactly what they, yep.
You know
yep,
what I mean?
Yep.
These people, the average person is on a low level. Because they're uninformed. They're unintelligent. They're just walking, talking, fucking zombie retards.
That's right.
But look, I got a scripture for you about this deception. 2 Thessalonians 2 and 7. For the mystery of iniquity doth already work. Only he who now letteth will let until he be taken out of the way. And then shall that wicked be revealed, whom the Lord shall consume with the spirit of his mouth, and shall destroy with the brightness of his coming, even him whose coming is after the working of Satan, with all power and signs and lying wonders, and with all deceivableness and unrighteousness in them that perish, because they receive not the love of the truth, that they might be saved. And for this cause God shall send them a strong delusion, that they should believe a lie. Did it really say that word? Oh, it said.
Watch, this is about to change.
Drunk Ohio. Because everybody's got goddamn AIDS.
They
got
to celebrate.
Town,
a fun family oriented event.
150 motherfuckers within the last few months on HIV process. Like, just popped out of nowhere. Can you imagine them 150? You know, at least 149 of them is fucking somebody else.
Yeah, because look at all that foul shit these people can do.
I see 150 of them. Shit. I'm going off.
That's because all these men out here, they're like, they're bisexual freaking freaks. You know what I'm saying? They adulterers. They you know, commit all kinds of acts of adultery, homosexuality, bestiality. All the women are whores. Everybody's fucking everybody, and diseases are just festering and just growing. And, you know what I'm saying? And spreading.
Nobody's taking that woman.
Nope.
Yeah, they throw it, going one ear and out the other, man. Everybody.
But you know what I'm saying? Syphilis, that's a wicked man's punishment.
Yep.
You know, so that's what you get for committing adultery.
That syphilis is bad, man. That changes your whole, it changes your biological, man.
Yeah.
Biologically, it changes your body, man. Mm-hmm. Kills you slowly. You go lose your hearing, you lose your sight, you lose your life. Shit.
Ain't that what killed Al Capone?
Al Capone is probably what killed the Edomite.
Emperor Tiberius?
No, probably him too. I'm talking about Greece. I'm going back to Greece.
Alexander.
Alexander, you go. I knew the scripture to go to Maccabees 1.
They said he got sick. Sick and died.
Because he was a nasty motherfucker, man.
He was fucking everything.
Yeah. Nasty as all fucking hell, man. Him and the other motherfuckers after him.
Because then he had his lover. His name was Hephaestus or something.
That's crazy, man. Oh, nasty motherfucker.
Go ahead.
Isaiah 66 and 4. I will also choose their delusions, and I will bring their fears upon them. Because when I called, none did answer.
Isaiah 51:41, but it's going to go with this.
Oh, okay.
I will also choose their delusions and will bring their fears upon them. Because when I called, none did answer. When I spake, they did not hear. But they did evil before my eyes and chose that in which I delighted not.
That's beautiful. That goes with the wisdom of Solomon tree.
Yep. Yeah, because on top of all that wickedness, they commit adultery and faggots. These people into some spiritual wickedness too, man.
That's their reward.
Their first fear is probably starving to death. Come back. That's what the first fear.
Yeah.
Woo.
Yeah, because when those EBTs go down, that's a wrap.
Can you imagine?
Because we see it all the time. We be in the store, and the EBT might go down for 10 minutes, and everybody loses their goddamn mind. Just think what happens when it goes down for good. We're going to rejoice. We're going to praise the Most High.
Oh, yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Man, I'm about to leave. I can't fucking stand.
What's wrong?
My fucking hip is killing me.
Okay. Go ahead. Are you
good? Just sit down right there, Paul, and do it. Just sit down and hold the camera, man.
All right, go ahead.
I ain't holding the second one, though. You know what I'm saying?
Hold up.
What the fuck happened? You getting a battle? Shit. You know Paul got a metal rod in his leg.
Oh, sorry.
That's why I was telling you he almost died in that car wreck.
Iron Man.
Shit, I remember having dreams, like, before I came to the truth. Like, I was 12 years old. I used to always have dreams of evil spirits and shit. It used to torment the fuck out of me.
Right. And as a young man, that shit's real as fuck. Yeah. Well, actually, it was. What the fuck am I saying?
Yeah.
It was real. I mean, you know, it's just what they do. The demon spirits do what they do.
Man. Yeah, I used to have bugged out dreams, too. Yeah.
But now they know, you know now, they ain't nobody to fear.
You were talking about some spirits of wickedness. In the house that we grew up in, one day my dad was redoing the floor in the kitchen.
Parsons.
Yeah, right off Parson on Wager.
Right.
Where you, bro? Are you going home?
Yeah, I can't fucking stand.
You fucked up, huh? Alright, man, we'll see you later.
Right. That's cool, you're alright.
Yeah, I was going home.
But the house I grew up in, You pulled up. My dad was redoing the floor, right? He popped up the old tiles, and on the floor was a pentagram.
Oh,
like an upside down pentagram with a bunch of, I don't know what a, I was just a kid, so I don't remember. But there was all kind of weird writing. It's probably Hebrew or something. I couldn't understand.
Right.
You know, devil worshippers use Hebrew. You know what I mean?
Sorry.
You ever see a famous pentagram? Just look up on Google Images. Just type in upside down pentagram, Baphomet, something like that. And you'll see how it has the Hebrew inscriptions around the pentagram.
Straight up?
Yeah. Right. You devil worshippers, because they worship Satan. Right. Satan's in the Bible.
Right, right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But yeah, with that shit.
Damn, I'm tripping. They using Hebrew?
Yeah, because that shit, even when you read Albert Pike's book, The Morals and Dogma, one of Albert Pike's books, he breaks it down how he uses, he actually used Samaritan Hebrew.
Right.
Which is a little different, you know what I mean?
Right.
But because the Hebrew, they used the fake Jews, they used the Kabbalah. Because the Kabbalah, that's that mysticism, that magic shit that them fake Jews are into. You know what I'm saying? Which really goes back to Babylon. But anyway, it's a proof, because the house we's living is in the hood. Some Jakes was living in there, and they was doing some kind of satanic ceremony up in that house.
Of course.
And I used to have nightmares up in that house. You know what I'm saying?
Doing what they were put here for.
It was just some freaky shit, man.
Right. Here you go. This is Isaiah 47:1. Come down and sit in the dust, O virgin daughter of Babylon. Sit in the ground, there is no throne, O daughter of the Chaldeans. For thou shalt no more be called tender and delicate. Take the millstone and grind mill, uncover thy locks. Make bare the leg, uncover the thigh.
Make bare the leg, uncover the thigh.
Pass over the rivers. Thy nakedness shall be uncovered, yea, thy shame shall be seen.
Yeah, so that nakedness is talking about how we bringing all this truth out. We exposing all this wickedness. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Keep going.
I will take vengeance, and I will not meet thee as a man.
Yeah, so when the Lord comes back, he's coming out of the sky with legions of angels in his full power. He ain't coming back like he did 2,000 years ago. He gonna come around and, you know what I'm saying, heal people and be teaching everybody. Nah, he's coming back to kill and destroy. He's going to come back to tread that wine press.
That's right.
And stomping heads like grapes. That's what the Lord is going
to
do.
They ain't going to be able to poke him down. As for our Redeemer, the Lord of hosts is his name.
Oh, yeah.
The Holy One of Israel.
Let me get that precept just real quick. Like you said, would you say they ain't going to poke him again?
Right.
Revelation 1:7. Behold, he cometh with clouds. That's those chariots. And every eye shall see him, and they also which pierced him. And all kindreds of the earth shall wail because of him. Even so, amen.
That's right, that's right.
And that says the same thing as what he's reading right now.
Right, right. And that, like you sent me that, what's that, alien definition?
Hey, $1 for the homeless? I'm trying to catch Dakota bus.
Yeah, all right, bro. Same deal.
Yeah, they looking for UFOs. And
oh, yeah, yeah, the UFOs. Oh, that's bugged out. I was getting bugged out this weekend. But I was just thinking about it, man. I was thinking aliens. What the goddamn alien bullshit? But when you think about it, how do you spell the word God in Hebrew? The word God in Hebrew is Allah. It's Allah. Its singular form is Allah, right? Which means power. And the plural form is Allahayim. Well, some people say Elohim, but that's wrong. It's Allahayim. Like the scripture says, in the beginning, Allahayim created the heavens and the earth. It says that we were made after the image of the Allahayim, after the image of the gods. Okay, meaning after the image of Yahawashi, the Son of God, and after the image of the angels. Okay. So, but you see the way it's spelled is Allahayim. And then you got these devils making all these TV shows about the ancient aliens. Well, the word alien is spelled almost identical to Allah. It's A-L. You know what I'm saying? And then the plural form would be aliens. So, I mean, I don't know if that's just a coincidence or they did that purposefully. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, he's on this shit, man.
Because they trying to get everybody thinking that aliens are the enemy. Just like all the movies you see. Because the Lord ain't no goddamn alien, okay? He created this earth. But every movie you see, they always show the aliens as the bad guy. Like Will Smith in Independence, they had to go fight the aliens with your boy, what's your boy, Dennis Quaid? Not Dennis, was it Randy Quaid? It was retarded ass. It's the fat sister. They be getting it in, bro.
That's that old group, the weather group.
That's the pointer sister.
Those are the aliens.
Yeah, that's some aliens.
That is some aliens.
That really is aliens, bro.
Alien, one of the definitions for aliens is strange.
Strange, that is strange.
That's some strange shit to see a woman built like that.
They look good as hell if they would just eat right, not eat pork and shit. Yeah. Follow the laws, man, they be looking great, man.
Right.
I be trying to get their number.
So when they do see the Lord, man, it's going to be a strange thing to them.
Yep.
They look for everything else but the Lord to come out of.
Yeah, and when the Lord does return, I wouldn't even doubt if they get on the TV or something, like, oh, we're being invaded by a hostile force.
That's what I see
must fight against them.
That's what I see happening to
them. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like you said, the Lord ain't no goddamn alien. Look, the angels is here on the earth right now. Okay, they up in outer space, they on the earth, they up in, you know, the four corners of the earth, just stirring shit up.
That's right.
Oh, just go back to that one thing, that Russian cosmonaut. Just get on, you can get on YouTube or whatever, look up Russian cosmonaut, seen an angel or something like that. But there's an interview with a Russian cosmonaut, he was up there flying around way up high, way the fuck out there. And he said he seen a giant celestial being with a human face flying around outside of his ship. It's always the Russians saying some crazy shit too,
at it. Yeah. Fucking NASA censoring shit too much.
Yeah.
Fuck NASA.
But I thought America had freedom of the press.
There you go. This is wisdom.
America is the land of the free, but we got more prisons and more prisoners than the rest of the world combined. That makes sense.
Here you go, wisdom of Solomon 5:1. Then shall the righteous man stand in great boldness before the face of such have afflicted him, and made no account of his labors. When they see it, they shall be troubled with terrible fear, and shall be amazed at the strangeness of his salvation, so far beyond all that they look for. Here you go. Ain't looking for the Lord to crack the stars. They looking for
aliens and
right. The
grays and the what they call the tall whites. Mm. Man, these people are bugged out, man. Mm. It is getting worse by the day.
Yeah.
Like I told you, that flat earth theory, that's spreading like wildfire. People actually believe that shit.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, it's spreading.
Yeah.
I see it more and more every day. It's getting more popular. The motherfuckers actually believe that dumbass shit. Like, you have to be mentally fucking retarded to believe the earth is flat.
Shit.
I mean, where does the sun go when it goes down?
That's some shit Esau was talking when he was coming out the cave.
Yeah, talking about the earth was flat.
Right.
And we were clowning on him, laughing at his ass.
Stupid shit.
The earth is flat.
The earth is flat.
Mm-hmm. Don't you think we would have got a picture of the edge of it by now? That don't even make no sense. This is the dumbest shit I've ever heard in my fucking life.
Israel open his mouth, you're gonna hear some amazing shit.
Like you said, like he brought up that good point though, that flat earth theory. That's that Egyptian mythology. Because the Egyptian mythology said that when the sun went down, it went down to the underworld where Osiris was. You know what I'm saying?
You're right. I know when you was in the military, at one point you called somebody. And it was light there, and it
yeah,
was
always.
Day there.
I was in Japan.
Right.
I lived in Japan. I was calling people, asking what time it was. It'd be like that. I'm like, is the sun up there? I'm like, yeah, it's not. I can't see it over here.
Right.
If the earth was flat, you'd be able to see the sun where I don't.
Right.
People are dumb. People are stupid. And I know you, I know y'all watch our videos too, you flat earthers.
Here you go. This is Isaiah 28:21. For the Lord shall rise up as in Mount Perazim. He shall be wroth as in the valley of Gibeon, that he may do his work, his strange work, and bring to pass his act, his strange hat.
Yeah, the Lord, you were talking about strange and bugged out. The Lord's going to bring some bugged out shit upon this earth.
Yeah.
It's going to be marvelous.
Yeah.
Shit, never.
Look at you like you crazy. You're giving them the mistress.
Remember that dude, it was, I forgot, like the Persian king or something in Daniel's. And it's like the writing on the wall.
Oh,
and
yeah.
And he got so scared that his knees, like caved, like,
buckled on it.
Yeah, like, that's how scary the sight is and shit. Yeah.
Yeah, the hand actually came out the sky and wrote some stuff on the wall. Hey, that's why that old saying comes from it. The writing is on the wall.
Yeah, that nigga's so.
The writing's on the wall.
That is, yeah, that's dangerous.
This place is fucking finished.
Ah. Oh.
That's crazy, dude. Evil spirits, something else, though.
Huh?
Evil spirits, something else, though.
This shit, evil spirits is everywhere.
Yeah.
That flat earth shit, that's an evil spirit.
Yeah.
That's a demon going around. That's Asmodeus going whispering shit in motherfuckers' ears. You know? Hey, you know they say Asmodeus was the demon of mathematics and science and knowledge and learning?
Damn.
I've heard some magicians say that. Yeah, they worship Asmodeus. They said that's the heaviest of the demons. One of them.
Yeah.
Well, he's loose now, though.
Because, you know, the top devil worshipers and shit, what do you think their favorite book is? They know the scriptures. And they, you know, they hate the Lord.
Habakkuk 1:4. Therefore the law is slack, and judgment doth never go forth. For the wicked doth compass about the righteous, therefore wrong judgment proceedeth. Behold, ye among the heathen.
Oh yeah, wrong judgment proceedeth. Like when you go down to them courthouses, you surrounded by the wicked. You go up in there and there's number of poor people getting robbed by the government all day, cat, taking everybody's money, locking you up. I told you I was in the courthouse last 2 weeks ago. Out in the courtroom over, I just heard this woman. She's just screaming, somebody please help me. What? Help me, save me. Because they was taking her ass to jail. She was begging and pleading for somebody to save her. And nobody saved her.
They ain't got no conscience.
She was screaming. It was just sounded like something out of a horror movie, her screams.
She really expect the motherfuckers to get up, I save you.
But no, because they're not. Because they're all fucking...
I'll save you.
Ain't nobody saving your ass.
Big ass S on your ass.
Everybody's scared to death of the government. They're not going to save you.
Scared to death.
Yeah. And them screams have been stuck in my head ever since, man. Because you know she didn't do nothing wrong, probably. Well, she probably did. She's probably a whore and adulteress, but... You know they probably got her on some bullshit charge.
Just like 99%.
Yeah. Half the crimes that so-called committed is with some traffic bullshit.
Right, right.
This shit's not even a crime. Traffic.
They lock you up over traffic.
You went too fast. You didn't put a seatbelt on.
What?
You know, you forgot to use a turn signal.
Tags expired.
Oh, tags expired. Because, you know, once your tags expire, your car stops working. If you drive without a license, your car will not start. Try getting your car and start it with no license. See if it starts. That's some faggot shit. Actually, soon when they start putting implanting people those microchips, that car will actually not start unless you have that the authorization on your chip.
Yeah, guns that won't start. Yeah,
smart guns. Oh, that's funny you say that. I was just listening to NPR yesterday or 2 days ago, and they did a piece on smart guns and how. They was trying to move forward in technology.
Yeah, it's coming. It's coming. We're good. People ain't gonna get rid of the shit they already have. Well, maybe they will. People are dumb.
Yeah, people are stupid. Because, you know, they got that old tired ass saying, come and take them. Look, y'all, they've already taken all your freedoms. You're never, ever going to use those guns for anything. Okay? You're already fully enslaved. You're a bunch of faggots. Okay? And you're not gonna do shit but make Facebook posts. You're a bunch of bitch, weak ass faggot bitches. Okay? Fucking come and take them. You're fucking slaves, okay? You're nothing. Think about it. The time has been gone and passed for y'all to been did something with your bullshit guns, all right? You ain't gonna do shit. You're a bunch of faggots.
You ain't fucking mine.
If they was gonna did something, they would have been did it 50 goddamn years ago.
Because that's all they talking about is their precious America's going down. We gotta do something.
This shit's been good. This shit's been down.
How long is it gonna take for y'all great Americans to rise up?
They ain't gonna rise up shit. They a bunch of faggots.
What y'all waiting for?
Exactly.
That bitch is done.
Yeah, what are they waiting for?
Right. Oh, brave, my proud, brave motherfucker.
They ain't got no bravery in them at all.
Right, they get 50 deep at a bar and get drunk, and then they brave
then,
as fuck.
Oh, then they'll fight their brother. Yeah.
Right.
But they ain't brave enough to do what we do. Because y'all a bunch of faggots, a bunch of weak bitches. Y'all never come out and teach the truth. Because it takes a man to do what we do. Because y'all too scared about what people think about you. Y'all scared to go out and, you know what I'm saying, the spirit of the Lord. The Lord ain't nowhere near y'all.
Right.
A bunch of faggots. Because the men in this country are a bunch of faggots. They are women. Yeah, the men are as women. The men, the new bitches are men.
I mean, they fucking each other in the ass.
They really do, man.
Yeah, they sure do.
You can see it. They be putting up ads talking about they. I ain't gonna get into it, man. They doing all kind of weird shit.
Right. Here you go, Jeremiah 49:22. Behold, he shall come up and fly as the eagle and spread his wings over Basra. And at that day shall the heart of the mighty men of Edom be as the heart of a woman in her pangs.
Yeah, Esau is a big fucking faggot in the world. You see them two Edom, three Edomites who was up here earlier. You see how weird they fucking look. Yeah.
Creepy as fuck.
Yeah, creepy.
No beard.
Weird, but these are the people that's ruling over us. Just look at the top, the most powerful people in the world are like some George Burns. What's that dude's name? Not George Burns. What's that dude off The Simpsons? That's what they remind you. The dude in charge of the Mr. Burns.
Oh yeah. Oh damn.
They're all weak and frail. But how do they hold? How they got so much power? Only the Most High could.
Yeah, he gave it to him.
The Most High gave them that power.
Yep.
It's the only way.
Yep. This is Jeremiah 40:51-30. The mighty men of Babylon have forborne to fight. They have remained in their holds. Their might have failed. They became as women.
That's the American man.
They have burned her dwelling places. Her bars are broken.
That's you know, there's a popular meme going around on the internet, and they show the 18, 19 year olds of the 1940s that showed them storming the beach in Normandy. Then they show the modern day 19 year old crying about his feelings and he needs a safe place to go. Where he, you know, his feelings don't get hurt.
Right.
That's like a popular meme going around.
That's some funny shit, though.
That's some funny shit, eh?
They exactly like that, too, man. Sensitive is all fucking
it's just sensitive. I always worry about being politically correct.
Let me find this one shit, man. We've been trying to bring this up for a minute, too. Fucking faggot-ass motherfuckers, man. That's all that's on their mind is doing some faggot shit, man. Ah, come on.
Like
come
they got
on.
The AIDS walk going on. They always protesting for faggots' rights. No wonder y'all a bunch of slaves.
The only people that don't have beards are women and children.
They went and deleted it.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, you know, the one when, how these high schools, that anal hazing is becoming
because the young men, they become more and more faggotized.
Yeah, I'm gonna find it. I'm gonna find that shit.
Cause now, to be a faggot has become mainstream. Before, people knew you gotta keep it in the closet. It's not cool to be a faggot, it's unacceptable. But now it's become mainstream. Now it's being encouraged. Yeah, you go suck some dick and. It's okay.
Hey, don't watch this movie, 50 Shades of Black with the brother Marlon Williams.
Oh, yes. Yeah.
The comedy. What's the younger one?
I forget.
Anyway,
it is Marlon, ain't it?
Some faggot ass shit, man. He's describing the taste of dick in the movie. His bitch that he was fucking with put a dildo up in him that was, bigger than my arm, man.
They had
the whole movie, man.
Then they had that one movie where they dressed up like women too.
Yeah, white girls.
Yeah.
What was that?
So you know they sold out.
Oh yeah, hell yeah, man. They just like short dudes.
Even your
Kevin
dude,
Hart.
Damon Wayans.
I hate that.
Remember when he was even back on that show they had? He was dressed up like a faggot, a tranny.
Yeah.
What's that?
White Chicks
with Jim Carrey.
White chicks.
In Living Color.
Yeah, the
TV show in Living Color.
Yeah.
That's where they all started.
Yep.
With Jennifer Lopez and Jennifer.
That's where she was dancing.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Imagine what she done did to get up.
That's really back when they really started pushing that faggot shit back then.
Yeah, it was picking up steam.
Yeah, it started. Now with the millennials, with the turn of the millennium, boy, this shit got out of hand.
Yeah, shit reset.
Mm-hmm. What you trying to look up?
Oh, I just got some more faggot shit to show, to read, you know, just for education.
Any Wi-Fi out here?
Yeah, my shit just, I don't know what's going on. This shit's going to restart again.
I ain't got no signal, do I?
You got Wi-Fi?
I'm gonna try.
I think I had some last time.
Yeah, that Cat Williams attacking Kevin Hart now.
Yeah,
he's coming out about a lot, talking shit about Kevin Hart being a faggot now.
Really?
Yeah, Cat Williams, man, he woke up to something, man. He must have saw something that scared the shit out of him, man.
He keep catching hell.
Yeah. I mean, I ain't feeling for the brother, but still, he's still coming forward, condemning that shit.
He told, wasn't that a Cat Williams? Who was that standard? No, that was, I was thinking.
The adulterer. I'll never support that nigga.
Who?
Cat Williams, man. That's an adulterer.
Now he walking around with all these kids that ain't even his. He adopted like a bunch of kids that ain't even his. Yeah, he's too weird anyway, man. He's
That's Prophet right there.
Who?
That's his name, Prophet.
Prophet?
Yeah.
They ain't gone on that skateboard.
Yeah, he a weird motherfucker too. That's my kid's cousin.
There's your girl whole kid right there. Man, they could just be friends, though.
I'm lovers, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, they friends.
Yeah.
BFFs.
The fuck is they walking like that?
It's America, boy.
Man, it could be mother and daughter.
Nah. Shit, it's a...
Hey, mothers and daughters be fucking, too.
No, that's some weird shit.
Yeah, mother and daughters fuck, too.
They do. I mean,
I saw the video on YouTube. Everybody seen that video? Mother and daughter.
Yeah.
She
yeah.
sucked her daughter's titty and everything. Wait. Then started beating her ass.
Well, you heard that's the new thing though, because they got gay marriage legalized. So soon the next two things on the liberal plate and their agenda is they're gonna make incest acceptable, because why not? You don't get to choose who you love, right? Because that's what they say. You don't get to choose. You was born like that. You was born.
Yeah.
That's just a natural attraction. You love them, so you can't judge them for wanting to have sex with their sister. And just because someone's attracted to children.
That's crazy.
That, you can't judge them for that.
That's where it's going.
That's where it's going. They're going to legalize incest and pedophilia. It's going to be legalized.
Dude married a 5-year-old because she had cancer. And she wanted to marry him and shit. I think you want to show me or somebody.
Oh, I saw that. Yeah. Right. That's crazy as fuck, man. And they actually did a ceremony in the hospital, I think.
Yeah,
that's fucking retarded.
You know, nobody spoke out against that. A grown-ass man, dude. It's so cute. That's so cute.
I was reading the comment boards. Two people was taking up for it.
That's crazy as fuck, man. Dumb motherfuckers.
I wouldn't even doubt they probably raped the little girl.
Man.
Damn, that shit working.
They probably did a sexual ceremony so she can live or something. I bet.
Yeah, this country's gone, man.
It's, you know, it's a beautiful thing to see this motherfucker crumbling apart.
It is, too. This shit is crumbling apart, literally before our eyes.
Yeah, it's funny as fuck.
The raggedy-ass piece of shit.
Right.
Yeah, it's shitty. It's fucking hideous. Look at that ugly-ass shit.
Precious. They should have did something about this shit falling apart a long time ago. Here we go. America male high school athletes just can't quit anal hazing, it says. This is on the DC paper.
And that's real shit, though. I mean, you see this goes down in the colleges, too. It ain't just high schools. It's just not an isolated incident.
Right.
If your son is part of a football team, he probably got raped in his ass to get on that team.
Well, the suburb schools.
Well, the suburb schools. Oh, they doing it in the high schools, too, though.
You talking about the city's public, the city school.
Yeah, they do it.
Man, it's happening here, too. Hey, man, when I played football, man, I ain't never took a shower in the dorm.
I never
took no shower.
If I ever took a shower at school, I always did it with shorts on.
No, I ain't never did it. Never.
Yeah, because you always got the one dudes, they walk around just smacking their shit, just making sure everybody sees their shit.
You got a little.
That's just some faggot shit, man. Yeah.
You know, doing little. Go ahead.
Doing pre, doing pre-ed, whatever you call it. I can't remember what you call it. This, the gym class.
And then the teacher be right there too, walking right.
Everybody take a shower before that is over. Nah. I'm funky all day long. I won't even funky anyway.
Hey, the scriptures say in the law, you're not supposed to look on another man's nakedness.
And they do that too. In the locker room looking at them.
That's against the scriptures. Little ass shit. Look, the Bible says though specifically, you're not supposed to look on another man's nakedness at all. That's why the militaries set up after the ancient Roman military, because they was all a bunch of faggots. You know, they encourage faggot behavior.
Greek gymnasts.
There ain't nothing biblical about this nation at all. America's a Christian nation.
Why you think faggot ass hand was cursed when he looked at Noah naked?
Exactly. That's because that's against the law.
Right. You can imagine the foul thoughts he had looking at his own dad.
Why the fuck the stalls be so damn close? Like, when I be elementary, people used to look over and shit.
That's because it's set up. And so when Esau comes in there, he get his peek on.
You seen the one.
It's just a trough.
There you go.
Everybody just pissing by everybody.
Just open,
yeah. I go to like the...
Hell no, I go outside and piss.
Hell yeah.
And some people like, oh, what, you scared?
Wait till they all done.
Like, no, that's fucking faggot shit, man.
You got a little dick,
That's against the laws of the Bible. You know what I'm saying?
It's pretty gay, actually.
That shit is on preschool schools, too, man. Them open stalls.
I wouldn't even doubt if a lot of these places got cameras hidden in the stalls, too. Especially now, all this new technology. I get almost all these public bathrooms probably got hidden cameras and shit.
Right.
There's some weirdo going, watching all the footage.
That's some nasty shit. That's crazy as hell. Yeah, imagine what the fuck they saying, man. Anyway, let me finish reading this. America's boy-on-boy anal hazing problem is in the news again. Digital penetration, pencil penetration, javelin penetration, and other...
Javelin? Javelin?
Hey, man, I'm like just reading.
What the fuck does that mean?
Like a, right, like
a
right.
Thing.
A javelin?
A javelin, man.
What the...
A javelin, man. A javelin. A javelin is that thing they run with and do that... Go over high walls and shit.
I know what a javelin is.
Oh, they put cough syrup and assholes now. Yeah, you know that cough syrup.
That's the quickest way to get fucked up.
Ain't that purple drink?
Yeah, I think so. Something like that.
Yeah, because that was big in the news. Because the butt chugging, we already covered that. Because that was probably down on OSU campus.
Man.
And that was in the news. Yeah, it's like. Yeah.
You're butt chugging, don't you?
Butt chugging.
Motherfuckers.
Man, this is crazy, man. Javelin penetration and other creative penetration methods continue to be part of bizarro rituals in high school nationwide. It's in high schools nationwide.
Just let me get the scripture, man.
What the hell is going on with America?
America.
Where the heck is this dude from? Who think he from?
I don't even care.
Like a... I don't know what the fuck. He's like a hamlight title.
This is nasty shit, man.
Let me just get the faggot scripture real quick. Yes. Just for edification. This is what the Holy Bible has to say about homosexual acts. This is Leviticus 20 and 13. If a man also lie with mankind, as he lieth with the woman, both of them have committed an abomination. They shall surely be put to death. Their blood shall be upon them.
That's right. So that time come when the Lord shows up, these people gonna be in their faggot ass sexual shit, man, doing the same shit, not listening. And they gonna get caught with their pants down and get vapor fucking logs.
Whew.
And get vapor logs.
Should be no sodomite amongst the children of Israel.
Beating it up in another man's ass, man. Beating it up like you fucking a woman, man. That's some nasty shit.
Yeah, that's nasty, man.
Yeah, that's just foul as fuck. The latest incident has rocked the suburban New Jersey enclave in Sayreville. Last week, Sayreville High School canceled the entire remainder of its perennial powerful football team schedule over it must have been a bad problem. They canceled the season over allegations that senior players would routinely pin freshman players to the locker room floor in masses. Then older players will put fingers in the freshman player's anus. But wait, there's more, it says. Sometimes as a bonus, the older players will place those same fingers in the young player's mouths.
What?
That's some fucking straight.
These are future great Americans.
That's it. Really though, you're right though. You remember, like all these politicians are getting caught up in all kind of scandals. Like Marco Rubio, he got caught. They got some old videos and pictures of him going to homosexual bath parties where he's in a pool and they're having a giant orgy. Dennis Hester, one of the old speakers of the House, that just came out.
Oh, just recently, yeah. Yeah. Yesterday or a couple days ago?
Yeah, because he was fucking all kind of little boys.
Yeah, this motherfucker was stealing money from some banking or some shit.
To cover it up, to pay him off.
Yep. And they still not really speaking bad about it.
And it's all, of course not. It's unfortunate that he got caught.
And he's going to do less than 6 months' time.
Yeah, that's
it. If he'll do that.
Well, ever since that new Pope came in.
Yeah.
Hey, almost took his ass out.
Yeah, I was scared.
Damn, leave him.
There's some black bitches driving their right.
Like, they about to fight. They rolled the window down.
Dumbass black bitches, man.
That's the worst driver.
They rolled by several times already.
The worst driver on the planet Earth.
The black woman. The woman.
She's worse than the Hamites. Yep. Hey, the goddamn Hamite taxi cab could drive better than her.
We mad as hell, man. Bitches out.
Hell
man.
Yeah, them bitches
are. He's probably scared of them.
Probably because these bitches, they act like men and they got deep voices.
Yeah.
And they're real aggressive. They're the alpha. They're alpha women.
That's fucking shame. Yeah, look at that bitch.
Them motherfuckers was floating, man. They was floating.
Motherfuckers be on their Facebook driving and shit. They don't even be paying attention.
Yeah, they're probably high on some fucking pills.
Yeah, high on Facebook at the same time.
They're talking shit to you. That's crazy. Okay, let me see if there's some more meat in this shit. It's unspeakably awful. It's also a nationwide phenomenon that shows no signs of slowing down. From June 2012 to June 2013, for example, there were over a dozen reported hazing incidents around the country involving high school boys who have sodomized other boys with foreign objects.
Missiles was popular. I mean, it's always people in high positions too. Like the football coach is probably the one who gave him the idea to ass rape each other.
Right.
And the football coach probably got the idea from the principal.
Yep.
Because you're gonna come to find out, it's always the people in the positions of power who are devil worshippers, Freemasons. You know what I mean? Pedophiles. Mm-hmm. That's why I came out in the news that there was an elementary school teacher jacking off in the children's lunches and feeding the children sperm. But people still they still send their children to school though. You know what I'm saying? That's real life. And they'll get mad at us for saying the truth instead of getting mad at the man that fed your children sperm.
Yeah, we're exposing these witches because that's what they are, witches.
They had a satanic thing under the basement of Chuck E. Cheese somewhere, I think in Ohio or something. It was like,
did you hear about all those Chuck E. Cheese is demonic as all hell. But you see they building temples to Baal all through the United States. They got building one in New York. Did you hear about that?
Around the world.
They're building temples to Baal everywhere.
I'd like to find out more research on why they doing. Well, I can understand they doing it everywhere.
There's already one temple of Baal right there, the state house.
Right.
That's the temple to Baal, because Baal is just a Canaanite name for Jupiter, or Zeus, the Lord of the Flies. You know what I'm saying?
She's getting it.
Baal's above.
She in there though. Got her jetpack.
Fuck it, man.
Yeah, I'll even do it by myself, you know what I'm saying? When nobody's looking.
I don't give a fuck. I go right up in the shit too. When you need. I've been out there collecting cans once. I got to the point I didn't give a fuck no more. I was like, I can get some guys to get this money.
That can's money laying around.
Yeah, there's money everywhere.
That should be our little pickup, man. You got it, man.
Yeah, because, you know, a few years back, I didn't have no money. And I didn't have no job. I just went around and started picking up cans everywhere. Got a little something out of it. You know what I mean? I used to get on my bike with a big-ass backpack and just go picking up cans.
Technique is a man of demons. Okay, I'm starting to fall. concerned for. As for our Redeemer, the Lord of hosts is his name, the Holy One of Israel. Sit thou silent and get thee into darkness, O daughter of the Chaldeans, for thou shalt no more be called Lady of the Kingdom. I was wroth with my people.
Oh, and then what they say about America too? Oh, Lady Liberty, they got the Statue of Liberty. Yep, yep. They try to say America, you know, she's just the beacon of light, the beacon of freedom and all this bullshit.
Where?
People believe that. Here it is.
Eat it all up.
Like
it
we
up.
Said, America got more prisoners and more prisons than the rest of the world combined, and people still talking about it's the land of the free. That don't even make no fucking sense.
That's the problem. Too much goddamn freedom to do what the fuck you want. That's why all these goddamn diseases flying everywhere.
Yep.
Free to do what y'all goddamn want. That's what they're doing. They're doing exactly what they want. Anything and every fucking thing.
Oh, yeah, that's the only freedom you got is right. The... Yeah, the only freedom you is to be to do some wicked shit. You're free to be, you know, do some wickedness. Yeah. Just don't drive over the speed limit.
Freedom of speech, but you can't threaten. Can't threaten nobody.
Yeah, you got freedom of speech, but just don't speak freely. Okay.
You see the dude in Detroit got arrested for defending his house, man. Dude came in, a known rapist, was that about to go in his daughter's room, and he came to
I beat
him.
The hell out of
beat
him.
Beat the shit
I've
out of him.
That.
Dude died, and they arrested him, man.
That's the faggot shit we got to deal with
up,
out here.
Man. That's fucked up, man.
Now, we put curses on this nation. Mm-hmm. We on the, in the name of the Lord, we put curses on America.
That's the same. That's that one nigga. Remember him?
Who's that?
That's that Puerto Rican, remember?
Oh, is that
yeah.
Him?
High Street, yeah.
Okay.
Look just like him.
Oh, the one that, yeah, that one that, right. Is that him?
Yeah.
Okay.
Look just like him. It looks the same. Ah, shit.
I hate this fucking place.
I hate it too. That's why we put curses on them.
And you can commit a crime. Did I say this? You can commit a crime. You can get out bail. All you gotta do is
pay. Oh, that's if you got money. If you got money to pay, you don't go to jail. But what if you're poor? Oh,
too bad. Justice, man.
Too bad for you. It's like Goodfellas. Fuck you, pay me.
So shouldn't that be
They make bonds high enough.
Yeah, the bonds should be high as hell.
So your debt, your bills will fall behind.
And then, then if you don't pay your taxes, they'll lock you up for that.
So that's not even treating nobody equal. So, like, pretty much if you got money, you can get out of prison. But if you don't got money, your ass is in there.
But that's what freedom's all about. See, you just, your problem is you haven't researched freedom enough.
Yeah.
Shit.
Free at last.
They take my freedom.
We're Israelites. We're the Israelites. You're a Hebrew Israelite.
Hebrew
Israelites. Right. You know, you ever read the Bible, man? You never read the Bible?
I did, like, years ago.
Okay, but check it out, man. When you read the Bible, it's the Bible. Look, let me tell you something. The Israelites that the Bible mentions is so bad of a nation of a people, we come with an instruction manual. Instruction manual is the Bible itself. So when you read the Bible, man, it's always mentioned Israel. Israel. We're Israel. We are.
I'll give you an example. You know, you've heard of the one they call Jesus, right?
But shouldn't it be like something like Islam, maybe?
No.
Islam is madness and confusion.
That's another God. What's the first commandment when you read the Bible?
I don't know.
To serve no other God before him.
Yeah.
No other God. And that Islam shit is another God.
Yeah. I be like...
That's not our people's heritage.
Oh, that's my bus. I'm sorry.
It might not be your bus. Is that where?
Yeah.
All right, man. Hey, you ain't no nigga or African American, you an Israelite.
You are insane to hell, sir.
Yeah, he would just not get on the bus.
The one that comes down, the one that comes down.
Where?
We just got off.
Oh, dude.
Oh, that.
We vexing the shit out of him.
He ain't nobody.
We vexing just on presence.
We always run into that guy.
Most I hate him, man.
He really must hate him, huh?
Yep. We vexing the shit out of him. You know, just
on
presence, man.
I was hoping you was gonna be the other one. The one that got you locked up.
We ain't seen him since.
Nah.
We ain't seen him since,
man. Little rat.
Yeah, right.
Hey, he could be. He might be dead.
Yeah. Save me for one of them. You know what I'm saying?
Bro, this shit is weird.
All of them will get it, man.
She got your boy. He about to... She cursing him out?
I don't know.
He's gonna take her home.
I'm watching
the dollar.
I be seeing him in Bexley. He really does. Yeah, he lives in Bexley.
He did say he lived in Bexley.
Yeah, I see him out there waiting on the bus.
He did say he lived in Bexley.
He must be too retarded to drive.
Well, just too stingy to spend money on.
Oh, maybe that too.
You know.
Yeah, want some service.
Cause them motherfuckers are foul motherfuckers.
They are stingy, bro.
They got money to travel the world, but they won't buy a pair of drawers. A clean pair of drawers.
They do not spend money.
Yeah, they foul, man.
They really are foul.
I went to one of their houses to get some cats a while ago, man. And some Jews' houses, too. And the house stink, man. It stink. It was old-ass 60s furniture, but it was dusty, but it was taken care of. You know, I can't explain it, man. It was just old-ass 50s, 60s. It was literally old 50s, 60s type furniture all around the house. And the house stink. But everything still looked new, though.
Look at that heathen.
Everything still looked new, but right. The house stink, man.
That's that smell of a heathen.
Oh, what's this smell? That's like all type of weird right there.
It's a strange. Yeah, it's a strange motherfucker. It really is, man. It's like living in the movie Hellraiser.
Right.
You saw them pinhead on the
wall. Oh, shit. That's a badass movie right there.
You know what I'm saying?
I love that movie.
These people give you nightmares looking at them.
Damn, I can't remember if it's Galatians or Ephesians. But the Most High said, he gave reference to the Israel of God, of him, his Israel, but not giving reference to the rest. Let me just find him.
Well, that's Romans, you talking about Romans,
I'm gonna find
Romans 9, right?
He's doing a search on the Galatians for Israel.
Oh, yeah, well, there's a couple scriptures like that. Really, you know what? You watch that movie Caligula and Tiberius' island, where you live on the island of Capri. America's like a giant island of Capri. It's just like a fucking freak festival. All kind of weird shit going down out here.
Imagine if you could see the spirits and shit. That's a naked eye.
Oh, you can see them, but when you look into their eyes.
Shit.
What'd you say? What's the key word you want to look for?
It says the Israel of God.
Oh, you got it?
No, I ain't got it yet. Hold on, I might find this.
I thought it was in Romans 11. Is that's not the one you was looking for?
Uh-uh, uh-uh.
That Romans 11, Romans 9.
Oh, I'll find it.
Galatians 6 and 16.
That's it. Hold on. 6 and 16. Oh, yes, it. Is it?
Yeah.
Oh, that's it. My bad. Sorry. Okay, Galatians 6:16. And as many as walk according to the rule, peace be on them, and mercy, and upon the Israel of the Most High.
Yeah, the Israel of the Most, because not all Israel are Israel.
Romans.
Because you're an Israelite don't mean that you're going to make it.
Right.
You mean? Right. The majority of our people got to be destroyed. Two-thirds of Israel got to be destroyed.
Got to.
They got to go, man.
Got to get faith.
Matthew 3 what?
I forgot. Somewhere John was talking to the Pharisees. He was like, don't just say that you're an Israelite. You can't be destroyed or something like that.
Yo, why don't you turn the camera?
Yeah.
This is so
That's Israel. That's fucking crazy. They bugged out.
Right. Let me read this Romans 9 and 6.
These are the people that crucified our Lord.
Right. Not as though the word of the Most High had not taken none effect. For they are not all Israel, which are of Israel.
Yeah, they're not all Israel, which are of Israel. That's it. Fucking tranny.
Oh, shit. What the fuck is that? That's nasty, bro.
See, that was a perfect example.
I caught that.
That was where he worked out.
Damn, that's
what I mean. With no shame. With no shame. Oh, I got a perfect scripture for that. With no shame.
This is amazing, man. And they're not going to change nothing about themselves until the Lord come and vaporize them, man. Because you can't tell these people they wrong, man. Because they was taught to do what they're doing ain't nothing wrong with it.
Oh, I got the perfect scripture for that, too.
Mom and dad don't have no goddamn sense.
They got none.
You know,
they the ones that raised them.
Right, grandma and grandpa.
This should go back many generations.
That's right.
Generation after generation.
I should say
degeneration after degeneration. They're all degenerates. Our people all become like, was that Jeremiah 2? How have y'all be turned into a degenerate vine? Y'all was planted a noble and righteous, you know what I'm saying, royal seed.
That's right.
Supposed to be kings and priests, but y'all a bunch of degenerates and roaches.
Right. Let me read this real quick. Hosea 4:6. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge.
And they got no knowledge, none. We went and did a
just a survey, ask people just basic shit, like, what, you know, where's the capital of the United States? What's the capital of Ohio? What's the governor's name? What's up? What's the vice president's
name? Shit, I don't even know. It took me
Shit. I guarantee you they can't find Israel on a map.
My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. Because thou hast rejected knowledge, I will also reject thee, that thou shalt be no priest to me, seeing thou hast forgotten the law of thy power.
And that's funny too, though, because they forgot the law of the power. Like, if we ask these people, the average, because they claim, I'm a God-fearing woman, God-fearing man, Lord. And they know everything about the Lord and the Bible, but ask them about the laws of the Lord that just spoke of. Ask them what kind of laws is up in the Deuteronomy. Ask them who gave the laws.
Right, their only laws they know are thou shalt not kill.
Yeah, that's it.
Thou shalt not steal.
They can't even tell you the whole Ten Commandments.
That's right, right.
They just know like two of them.
Right. Seeing thou hast forgotten the law of thy power, I will also forget thy children.
Yeah, so that's why, look, the children are forgotten. No, nobody give a fuck about your raggedy ass children.
Fuck.
Does it look like anybody gives a fuck?
Hell
no.
Weird.
This shit is ragged.
They don't give a fuck about their children. Yeah. I don't give a fuck.
No, look, they just...
Shit. They pretend like they give a fuck.
Hell no, they don't.
Their children a plate of pork chops.
Yeah, they talking about, I love you, baby, while they feeding them swine's flesh.
Mom, every child get a 2-liter pop.
The mom just using for money for a fucking paycheck.
That's all it is, a paycheck. Well, it's economic, there's, you know, economic reasons.
You can tell. You can tell she don't love them.
And they all hate their baby's daddy.
Yeah, hate them all. They act like they don't.
Because there's no such thing as a husband or a father. It's baby's daddies. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. And we call the baby mamas BM. That's a medical term for bowel movement. You know, refer to them as baby BMs.
Yeah, they BMs.
Yeah, baby mama, BM, bowel movement. It's the same, you know, same thing. It's a medical term.
A BM.
Yeah,
you a BM.
Damn. Look, little cute little thing.
Crazy, stupid motherfuckers.
She looked more interested in this.
They was just
them.
Looking the screen.
That's it.
Both of them was looking the screen.
They don't know no better.
The retard.
This parent ain't nobody watching.
Yeah, I got a perfect scripture though. Isaiah 3:8. For Jerusalem is ruined. And remember, Jerusalem is a people before it's a place. Because you got some dumbass who come out the cut and be like, oh, y'all ain't in Jerusalem. Y'all ain't even from Israel.
Go back to Israel.
Yeah. You get tired of hearing that old tired shit.
Same shit.
Isaiah 3:8. For Jerusalem is ruined and Judah is fallen because their tongue and their doings are against the Lord to provoke the eyes of his glory. The show of their countenance doth witness against them. They declare their sin as Sodom. They hide it not.
It's a wicked act, homosexuality.
Yep, that's what sodomy.
Lesbianism, all that stuff is a wicked thing. That's supposed to be shunned on. You're supposed to, you know.
Shun them.
Right. I don't give a damn if it's your mama, your daddy, your brother, sister, cousin, best friend.
Hey.
You know, it's a wicked act.
It's unacceptable.
That's right. And it's scriptural. You read the Bible before, haven't you? You've been to church, you know. What's that? Okay.
But that's good.
What? You said gay stuff. You said gay stuff?
She said that he's against it.
Oh, my bad. Okay, so I didn't hear you. My bad.
Because, you know, our people, they just grown up. Now, because it's legal, according to the government, for homosexuals to get married. That's crazy. That's just bugged out. You know what I'm saying? Let me read the rest of this. Woe unto their soul, for they have rewarded evil unto themselves. Say ye to the righteous that it shall be well with him, for they shall eat the fruit of their doings. Woe unto the wicked, it shall be ill with him, for the reward of his hand shall be given him. Oh, here's the key point right here. As for my people, children are their oppressors. Look at little demon children running around everywhere. Little bastards. And women rule over them. Now, because the woman's the new man now. And then the man is the new bitch. You know, women, now men are all feminine and weak. You know what I'm saying? They're all scared and limp-wristed. Everything's been flip-flopped. The woman, you got alpha women now. Women taking charge, cussing out the husband. Every TV show you watch, the woman's in charge of the house. That's all out of order.
She's the logical one. She's the one. Yeah, she's the one.
Yeah, she's the smart
strong,
one.
Strong, brave.
The husband's just a big dummy. You know what I'm saying? He's silly. He's stupid.
Stupid.
That's all part of that brainwashing. That's not the the proper order of the Most High is the Lord, or then the man, then the woman.
You say 11, 1 Corinthians? 1 Corinthians 11.
I got a scripture
for
that.
Is that the order or 2 Corinthians? I can't.
Yeah, yeah. I always get them two mixed up.
Romans 1 and 24. Wherefore the Most High also gave them up to uncleanness through the lust of their own hearts to dishonor their own bodies between themselves.
Yep.
Who changed the truth of the Most High into a lie?
Yeah, they turned the truth into a lie. That's why you got these 501c3 churches. They having gay marriages in these churches now. Talking about, oh, this is the new age. We in modern times. And it's okay to accept homosexuals now. That's a lie. Okay, that goes against the laws of the Most High. Plus, it spreads all kind of diseases.
Yeah.
That's chlamydia.
That chlamydia, that syphilis.
You know
what I'm saying? What
the fuck is that?
Freak.
Like, what the fuck?
You ain't supposed to raise your children like that, man.
Under no circumstances.
Hell no.
Under no circumstances.
That's wicked as hell.
You know, just, the Lord ain't making no exceptions. Like, oh, it's all right for him to be one.
Yeah, it's okay. You know, he's my cousin, so it's cool, though.
Right. He's been nice to everyone.
No respect to person. How many men have you seen without beards, man?
Without hair on the face.
Yeah, like...
Yeah, that's common.
That's like, you know, women have no beards, children have no beards, but a man's supposed to have a beard.
How stupid would that lion in the jungle look without a beard?
Yeah,
a lion would look dumb as hell without his beard.
You probably think he's a woman. Like, oh, that's a woman.
Yeah, that's the woman lion. I ain't worried about him.
Yeah, you go over
here. Lion, you know, if you cut a lion's beard off, he'd probably go lay somewhere, not even eat, and just die.
I can imagine that.
You know what I mean? Just be all depressed and shit.
I bet you Esau gonna do that too. Probably getting my deal.
Yeah.
You know Esau did it.
Yeah. What the fuck is that? That's fucking disgusting, man.
Shit is crazy, man.
Why the fuck does he keep walking back and forth?
That's the spirit getting riled up in it. You know what I mean? Yeah.
Probably plotting.
Yeah, when you start reading those scriptures and it stirs them demons up.
Yeah.
This is like last week we was out here Yeah, all the demons was coming out.
Man was full of words. Yeah. It was crazy.
Oh, the man's full of words. No, you can't tell where is this going.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Was that your boy last week?
Yeah, that dude was crazy, man.
I understand the word he was talking about.
We was trying to be cool with him for the longest until at the end of it, I had enough.
Yeah, he was doing some weird shit. Like, he was like mental or something. Like, had mental background or something.
But that's what happens is people get the truth.
What the fuck?
And then they're not built for the truth, so they just bug out, you know what I mean? They just turn into a big time weirdo. Yo, that happens a lot with people who get into the Bible. They just bug out. And they just turn into a fucking weirdo. They get real weird.
Who changed the truth of the Most High to a lie and worship and serve the creature more than the Creator? Who is blessed forever? Amen. For this cause the Most High gave them up unto vile affections. For even their women did change the natural use into that which is against nature. And likewise also the men, leaving the natural use of the woman, burned in their lust one toward another, men with men.
That's foul.
Working that which is unseemly, and receiving in themselves that recompense of their error, which was meat. And even as they did not like to retain the Most High in their knowledge, Yahweh gave them up over to a reprobate mind to do those things which are not convenient, being filled with all unrighteousness, fornication.
Oh, here goes our people. It just broke down to faggots and the lesbians.
Wickedness.
Confessiousness. That's all people.
Maliciousness.
Everybody covets their neighbor's shit. That's why every time a new pair of Jordans come out, people getting stabbed over Jordans in a line.
A new upload video, you know what I mean? The internet of some killing.
Yeah, some new killing. Shit. Every time, just wait till the new Jordans come out. Every time, like clockwork, someone gets stabbed in line. Go ahead.
That's crazy. Full of envy.
Oh, like when the new PlayStation or Xboxes or something come out.
Right
there, as soon as people getting robbed, right there on the spot.
I think it's crazy.
Full of envy. That's Israelites.
Or you get on Craigslist, and people be like, I got a PS4 for, $300. With a bunch of games, just come meet me over here. You go meet them. They know you got 300 on you, so they just got you.
Oh, dude. The dude, he was like selling shoes, whatever. And the dude, he stole his money, and he got out, and the dude ran him over, and his arm got chopped off the like a rail or some shit.
Wow. Didn't I show y'all my niece on the back page?
Yeah.
I showed y'all that. Yeah, she's meeting dudes at bars and wherever, and she's jacking the dudes, Africans and all that, man.
Oh, sorry.
That's what she's mainly doing.
What women's good for that? They get, yep, you know, they set your ass up.
This is crazy, man.
I heard women do it all the time. They be on Craigslist, Backpage, whatever.
Oh,
and you like, meet me at this hotel. You meet them at the hotel. And they be like, I'll be right back. And she don't come back. A couple dudes come back.
Got him.
That's fearful.
Full of envy, murder, like debate, that, deceit, like malignity, whisperers.
Whispering. They always murmuring, whispering, plotting, scheming. You know what I'm saying? That's our people.
Backbiters, haters of God.
Oh, they hate the Most High. They get mad. We have people threatening us with death over reading the scripture. I still ain't gonna get over that day when he was at the park teaching, and this dude in the same breath called the cops on us and also threatened to shoot us with his 9. Man, how did they do that? You called the cops and threatened to kill us at the same time?
And he was following us and shit.
Yeah, and he was following
like
us.
Like a fucking creep.
Yeah,
like
following us. He tried to follow us in the car, but I dipped on it.
Fucking weirdos, man. Then dudes try to kill us with them.
What was it?
I'm sorry, you cut. Anyway, the dudes with the dull ass knives and shit.
Oh yeah, dude came out with a knife.
Yeah. It was dull as fuck.
We had multiple times, but Humpty Dumpty, yeah, he tried to get
us. Oh yeah, he threw beer on me. But it was dull as fuck because the dude tried to cut himself.
It didn't even cut.
Like,
that would have been funny if he would have sliced his arm open.
It would funny if the Lord just made it sharp.
Watch out, I'm going to get his bag.
Oh, thank you. All right, my bad.
Yeah, it's crazy out here. You gotta watch out.
The spirit of Satan.
It's the legions out here just having a good time, man. All the demons is out here.
Awfully close.
Yeah, it's a real grind. The dirty of the dirty is out here, man.
Jeez, thinking close, boy.
Cutthroat. It's a religion. They're cutthroat.
They're cutthroat. They savages. They even boast about it, though. You know what I mean? Because if you want to be highly esteemed in a society, you got to be a killer. You know what I'm saying? You got to be a killer or a cutthroat, a savage. You know what I'm saying? You got to be evil. Exactly. Only evil people are highly esteemed in this place.
Let me read this. Backbiters, haters of the Most High, despiteful, proud, boasters, inventors of evil things, disobedient to parents, without understanding.
Hell, they ain't got no parents no more. The new parent is the state. But yeah, these people, they don't respect their mother and their father. Really? Just see the demons. See the demons on her.
Old church home. Right, come from church. Always got a different fly ass.
When the scriptures say don't be wearing the costly pearls and the all the bullshit, getting all, you ain't supposed to get all dressed up like that going to church. The scriptures specifically say not to do that. That's right there in what? Timothy? Yeah, because you know what I'm saying? That's what kills me about these people, man. You gotta get your Sunday's best. Well, the Lord got a problem with your Sunday's best. He gonna bury you in your Sunday's best. You know what I'm saying? See how good you look when you lying in a casket after you got ran over by a coda bus and pushed out the 20th floor of a building.
Worse than comes before then when she can't get no makeup,
yeah,
no perfume, no way to wash her stinking pussy. But she gonna have that clean shit to throw on her. Nobody's gonna tear that shit apart, man. It's a trumbo.
Chubba. I'm gonna get that scripture too, because that makes me angry, man.
What's up?
Because you know that makes the Lord angry. Yeah, I'm gonna get that Timothy real quick. Because you see these hoes, man, they be going to these churches. The men do it too, they be wearing their gaiters. They got their gaiters, they got their pinstripe suits. You know what I'm saying? You know, they, you know, Jake like the pinstripes. He got the the little thing in the pocket.
Right.
Either you got a flower in there, a handkerchief.
Yeah.
Ugly.
Jake got to be smooth with it, boy. Got to look good. That's in his eyes. He looked good with a dick tied around his neck. You know, he's looking good. In his mind, a dick tied around his neck. An upside down dick.
What the fuck?
You know, he looking good.
Getting it. Oh, shit.
And he probably got some fake gators on anyway.
Oh, you know they fake.
Right.
Let's not even talk about Issachar's boots.
Oh, Lord have mercy.
We ain't going to go there today.
Oh, Issachar take it to the extreme. Issachar.
All right, this is what the Lord said, how women are supposed to conduct themselves, right, in the church. 1 Timothy 2:8. I will therefore that men pray everywhere, lifting up holy hands without wrath and doubting. In like manner also that women adorn themselves in modest apparel.
Modest.
Tell that to these hoes. They'll look at you like you're stupid.
What?
And then call you evil for reading the Bible. They'll be like, that's bullshit. You judging. Why you judging? In like manner also that women adorn themselves in modest apparel with shamefacedness and sobriety. Not yelling at the top of your lungs, talking about you fitting to go ham. You know how these bitches do it. With shamefacedness and sobriety, not with broided hair. Or gold, that means your earrings and your necklaces and your bracelets and your weave and your rings and all the other bullshit you wearing. Not with broided hair or gold or pearls or costly array. So that just cut, that's a cut to every single church out there. Every church in the hood is not following the scriptures at all.
Not one
of them.
Not one.
Cause you go up in there and that's all you see is costly array. That's the only time these people actually they save them pearls and them golds and all just for church. Dumbass people. But which women professing godliness with good works, let the woman learn in silence with all subjection. But I suffer not a woman to teach, nor to usurp authority over the man, but to be in silence. For Adam was formed first and then Eve. And Adam was not deceived, but the woman being deceived was in the transgression. Notwithstanding, she shall be saved in childbearing if they continue in faith and charity and holiness with sobriety. Hey, but there's some good women out there though, right?
Where?
How many women do you know up in these churches follow that? When you go up in there, you think it's like you went to the Oscars or the Grammys or something. Right. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
You are the BET Awards.
Here's a scripture for their churches. Jeremiah 5:7. How shall I pardon thee for this? Thy children have forsaken me and sworn by them that are no gods when I have fed them to the full. They then committed adultery and assembled themselves by troops.
Oh my.
In the harlot house.
In the harlot house. That's churches are harlot houses. That's what they are.
Yeah.
Poor houses. Just like that movie, you remember that one movie, Boys in the Hood? Remember that one part in the movie? He's like, if you want to get some pussy, you gotta go to church. Remember
right,
that?
Right. That's what they said. Same thing in what's the Eddie Murphy movie, Coming from Africa or Coming to America?
Oh, yeah.
When he went to the barber shop, and they were like, you want to find a good girl?
You got to go to church.
You got to go to church. Now, that's where you're going to find the hoes at.
Good hoes.
Man, church is some wicked shit, man.
I can't.
That's some wicked
you
shit.
You ain't gonna
man.
Catch me up in there.
Yeah, if we do, you're gonna be in there cutting them off.
I've already been talking to girls too, like, you gonna go to church with me.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? I'm like, nah, I ain't going nowhere with you.
Oh my God.
She'll stop talking to you for that. Good your girl. Keep in shape for me.
They stay in shape too.
Yep. Our women ain't gonna stay in shape.
Fat fucks. Oh,
yeah.
You see our women, they can barely even get on the Coda bus. They gotta wobble up in there. They get so fat they can't walk, they gotta wobble.
Right, grabbing the rails.
Yeah, grabbing the rail. And then when they got on the bus, they're breathing all heavy. Cause they just, going up them two steps on the bus was like a flight of steps to them. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
All tired and out of breathing, wheezing and shit when they breathing.
That's some amazing shit.
They've been done smoked two packs of porch already.
And an ounce of weed.
Yeah, the ounces, yeah. Got the swishers.
Well, all women love smoking.
They do too, don't
they? They smoke anything.
They'll smoke you out.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I remember Tito was like, man, I got to switch, man, but my bitch pump.
He can't stop.
Can't stop. Walk around like a sign. What's up, man? Hey, what's your Puerto Rican?
No, I'm Mexican.
So you Mexican, huh? You know that's your real name right there.
Issachar.
Issachar. You're Issachar, right? You know the Bible? You read the Bible?
I read parts.
Yeah, but you know, when you read the Bible, we're the people of the Bible that the Bible speaks of. Israelites. You're an Israelite, man. That Mexican shit is just the name the white motherfuckers gave you, man. Like they call me an African American nigga. That's right, that's what I'm saying. We're from the same nation, but we're within that nation is 12 tribes. We're the same nation, we're the same people. You know? Most like bad as hell, man. He made 12 different nations out of one, 12 different tribes out of one nation, man. We gonna be the fucking future rulers of this world.
Yep.
We are, you know? You know?
We setting it up right
that's
there.
What, that's why we out here. That's right. We setting it up.
Well, the Lord words. Setting it up.
Yeah, spread the word. That's what you supposed to be doing. The same thing.
Right. I do spread the word sometimes. You know?
Right. But this is what you're supposed to do. We gotta teach you how to understand this Bible the correct way. You know? You can read it on your own, but like I said, we gotta...
I never read it from the beginning. I always read it. I just open it.
Yeah, that's how you spoke.
Hey, let me just get that for you.
The Bible actually tells
is
you.
It's about to rain, man.
It did feel it. We'll be all right. It's about to rain missiles. Soon when they start shooting the missiles, it's going to be a wrap. All these buildings, they all going to be destroyed.
It is raining.
All up. That's what's coming. That's why we out here.
Oh, shit. We're going to have to cover them signs up. I got it. Go ahead.
Here you go. Just check this out, man. This is Isaiah 28:9. Whom shall he teach knowledge, and whom shall he make to understand doctrine? Them that are weaned from the milk and drawn from the breast. For precept must be upon precept, precept upon precept, line upon line, here a little and there a little. So it's just a spiritual thing that you do exactly what you do. You just open the book up to right reading. But that's now we can give you more to read.
Yeah, that's what I do too. I got this.
I do believe in it, you know.
Right. Well, of course, you're an Israelite. It's in your spirit.
Oh, there you go. So you know you're Spanish. So you know, you know what I'm saying?
Hey.
Because the Lord was a dark-skinned man. You know what I'm saying? He didn't have long hair either. The Bible says that you're not allowed to have long. A man's not allowed to have long hair.
I had long hair before.
Well, you know, I did too. Now I got none.
You got a beard. You see that beard on?
Yeah. Oh yeah, we're not supposed to shave our beards off either.
You can't even do the brown. You can't even edge it up.
I'll give the scripture on this.
You can trim it down, but you can't edge it. You can't do none of that edge.
A man's supposed to have facial hair.
That's right. Yeah, look like a man.
Not
a
looking,
lion. Look like a lion.
Yeah.
You know?
Looking all smooth like a woman.
Right.
You know what
right.
I mean?
I can't, man, this is beautiful, man, how this nation's going to fall apart from us getting together, and the word is coming out before its actual destruction comes, you know?
We just paving the way for the Lord.
That's all we doing. That's all we doing. Our job.
You know, the scripture said we're going to rule all nations. Let me get a scripture for you. You in a hurry, right? Let me get you.
I'm not in a hurry.
Oh, okay. I got you. You know that Revelation is heavily used.
Hustle, bus,
yeah, Issachar, man. That's your name. It means he is higher.
About to die.
You say you waiting on the bus?
He's higher.
I'm trying to hustle a bus, man. Trying to hustle somebody.
Right. Where you going? How far are you going?
Sawmill.
That's way up there. That's up by you.
That's up north.
That's Columbus Zoo, kind
of. Oh, you way up there?
Dang.
Oh, that's right. There is a lot of Issacharites up that
is
way.
It?
But when you get off of, when you get off of 270 onto Sawmill, you go left, right? And it's further, a little bit further down, that's where a lot of y'all at, right? Yeah, I know. I'll be up there all the time.
Hey,
you know? But there's some badass bitches up that way, too. A lot of badass white women. Woo-wee!
That's where the money's at up there.
Yeah.
Check this out. This is our inheritance right here. Cause you know this Bible, this book, this is the book of our forefathers. This is our inheritance. It's got the history of our people in it, our traditions, our laws, you know what I'm saying? And it's got prophecies of the future in it. But peep this, Revelation 2:25. But that which ye have already, hold fast till I come. And he that overcometh and keepeth my works unto the end, to him will I give power over the nations. And he shall rule them with a rod of iron, as the vessels of a potter, they shall be